Serious, police officers of Reddit, have you ever had to arrest a relative so friend? If so, what was it like afterwards? Former federal agent. I had to arrest a former partner who I graduated the academy with. He was a good guy, was involved in a shooting and never recovered. Turned to alcohol, marriage went south, everything went downhill. After an incident where he started shooting out the windows on his house, the local cops cordoned off the area and notified our agency. We talked him down and convinced him to come with us. Arrested him and we drove him to the local PD where they processed him. He was terminated and a senior agent was reprimanded for covering up a previous alcohol and firearms related incident. I spent around 2 years as a special constable for the Met Police. The unit I joined would mostly work nighttime violence, for example, when pubs and clubs close, at any borough that requested our assistance, and so we could be in any borough that night. One night shift we are in my home borough, I'm in the van and we're circling round near where I live, which was a bit of a novelty. Normally being anywhere in London means I have no clue where I am. A call comes down to reports of a burglary and I freeze as it's my neighbor's address. We arrive and speak to the family, a young Muslim couple who have just gotten married a few days ago, and they looked more surprised to see me than I them. They heard noises and came downstairs to find someone in a mask rooting through drawers, who scarpered out the back door when spotted. At around this time the door knocked, and it's my girlfriend again surprised to see me, who says there's someone in our garden. Here we go, this could be a good job. My garden at the time was pretty secure. Unless you can scale walls, you aren't getting out. My colleague goes in through the front door whilst I jump over the wall from the neighbors and immediately get jumped by someone. They were pretty weak and I easily overpower them as my colleague arrives baton drawn. After arresting and cuffing, we get the lights on and I find it's someone I've been friends with since school, who we had just had round with his wife for dinner a few nights ago. Turns out he knew that our neighbors had gotten married and had planned to burgle them for their jewelry and wedding gifts. Suffice to say, I am no longer in contact. He got sent down for 2 years and only got released a few months ago. I arrested my sister 2 years ago. We are fine now. Story. 2 years ago I stopped by my parents' house while on duty to have a cup of coffee with my father. When I got there I heard screaming from the backyard and went out to see what was going on. I saw that my sister had my mother pinned to the ground and was kicking her violently, multiple times, while screaming and swearing at the top of her lungs. I tackled her to stop the attack and she began to punch and kick me too. The neighbors had come outside to see what was going on and my sister would not calm down. My mother was badly injured and it took my father and me both to get my sister under control. She was fighting like I've never seen someone fight before. She was biting, clawing, kicking, and tried to gouge out my eyes. I had no choice but to disengage and use pepper spray in an attempt to subdue her. It worked and we finally got her under control. I called for an ambulance to evaluate my mother and my sister was transported to the station by another officer. The story I found out later was that my mother had found methamphetamine in my sister's car, and when she confronted my sister about it, my sister lost it and attacked her. My sister was admitted to a drug rehab facility and has been clean, as far as I know, ever since. We have a good relationship now, although we'll never be best friends or anything. Michigan cop here. I got a call on the 5th of July from Alcohol Treatment Services stating that two guys who were out on bond blew hot due to partying from the night before. When I got there, one of the guys was a good friend of mine. The hard part was his dad, who always took great care of me, was standing right there while I hooked him up. They were super cool about it, but I still feel bad. On the way to the jail we caught up and talked about family. As a recovering addict who works in the recovery field, I'd just like to let you know that that type of experience could have a great, positive impact on your friend. Getting arrested by a stranger is one thing, and can easily be shrugged off. But getting arrested by a friend in front of your father can cause some serious self-reflection. Police officer here. Got called to a verbal domestic and quickly learned after speaking with the female that her old friend's dad was cheating on his wife with her. I had my partner take over the investigation as I didn't want to be biased. Anyway, guy shows up, we have an awkward chat, and everyone is cautioned not to contact or communicate with each other anymore, and both parties are in full agreement. Female doesn't want to ruin his life and he says he is done with his cheating ways. 2 hours later the female calls and tells us that he drove by her house a few times after we left. I call him and give him a second and very stern caution to give her some breathing room or he will be charged with domestic criminal harassment. I try to make him see reason and it seems to work. No more calls for the rest of our shift. The next morning I am brushing my teeth before heading into work and I get a phone call from him saying that he screwed up and left a note on her car last night. She called a different cop who issued a warrant for his arrest after reading our reports that he had already been cautioned twice. He asked what to do. I told him to report to the front desk as soon as I got to work and he complied. Then my partner from the previous day and I arrested and booked him for criminal harassment. Some people just don't get the hint. XNSW police officer here. I was in the car with another constable. Check bona fides came over. Just means find out what's going on. Often due to horrible smells. Arrive at address in industrial area. Clearly drugs being cooked because no one is burning that crap at 3 a.m. unless it's illegal. It smelled horrible. Male comes outside to immediately give himself up. I secured him whilst my partner went in. Turns out the second one was my partner's longtime family friend. We both had to go on forced leave after while another lack investigated to make sure there was no criminal activity on our behalf. They take that shot pretty seriously in Australia. Turn out the raw materials would have equated to around 10 mil street value. As a military police officer in Hawaii, I became really good friends with a guy in my unit. Babysat his 4-year-old, was invited over for family dinners, and everything. Go into shift with him one day when I am told to relieve him of his weapon and cuff him. Ended up having to wake his wife up, who thought I just stopped by for breakfast lol. To investigate a domestic violence report that his mother-in-law called in from NC. Ended up that she wanted to go home. He didn't want his kid to leave. They got in an argument, and she called home to tell her mom about the argument they had. The military makes the service members leave their homes in these situations. But of course the barracks were full. So less than 12 hours after I handcuffed him, guess who's sleeping on the floor of my room? I think he stayed for a few weeks before we got on each other's nerves lol. He wasn't mad at me about it. I was doing as I was ordered. But it was extremely difficult, though I think I stayed professional throughout, interviewing his wife, my friend, to get evidence to convict him of a crime. It was also awkward with my buddy, because I obviously couldn't discuss the case with him. He understood and didn't ask me much about it. I think the worst was, during and after the investigation, that I felt some guilt for not knowing what was going on and trying to help in some way. I also felt like I was tearing apart a 4-year-old's family, though it was obviously on the way out already. Typing this one for my dad. Back in 2006, it was nearing the end of second shift and I was ready to get off. The call came in of a shooting. I was about a mile away tops, so I was first on the scene by a lot. I head inside. Check the bedrooms and find two men dead from shotgun wounds. I knew them. Family friends from growing up. Good people, but crap heads. You know what I mean? Always getting into trouble. Never big things. Just drugs here. Public intoxication there. Nothing huge. Well, they ate it that day. What got me, though, was I had seen their older sister earlier when I pulled over her friend. It's just weird how you can see someone and talk about the family quick and a few hours later know that she's about to find out how much she's just lost. They were still warm. So, I continued my search. Fast, as I called in the ambulance, I check, find the back door ajar and head out. I get a call saying that the shooter was still in the neighborhood as someone just reported him, not a block away within the last 2-3 minutes. Going through the backyards and across alleys. Other officers are now in the area and we're hunting him. I see movement. It's him. It's the guy. The shooter. No weapon to be seen. Thankfully, I got him in my sights. Yelled to him to stop where he is. Thank freaking God he does. Pistol still drawn on him. I get him on the ground. Cuff him. And think for a moment. Shoot him. He freaking deserves it. Another officer is now on the scene with me. Gets me off the shooter's back and pushes me aside. I sit down next to his cruiser and cry. After, I end up smoking about a pack of cigarettes before I get home. I had quit in 1994 and this was the first and only time I broke down and smoked. I put in my retirement papers 2 weeks later. That sounds rough as heck, but kudos to him for upholding what's right and wrong even in a situation as messed up as that. I'm sure a lesser man would have tried something to exact revenge in that scenario. Last week I arrested a guy I went to high school with for misdemeanor destruction of property that myself and several other officers witnessed. I didn't know it was him until after we got to the station and I began getting his information. His driver's license had his old address on it and the city was where I went to high school. I immediately recognized him. He was 2 grades above me but had a sister who was my age. He was very intoxicated and upset about the whole situation, so in order to bridge the gap and get him to calm down, I told him we went to the same high school and that I knew his sister. I thought he might get upset, but it was a risk I needed to take. I started asking him how he'd been and we talked about the various mutual friends we had. He started to calm down, which was nice, and earlier he had been very tense, upset, and erratic. When we realized how many mutual friends we had, he asked me not to tell anyone out of embarrassment, though what he did was a matter of public record. I promised that I wouldn't, since part of good policing is the ability to have good discretion. I explained to him the arrest process as best I could and told him that he would be out in about 3 hours. Once I was able to turn him over to the cell block technicians, I immediately looked him up on Facebook and blocked him. Prior to blocking him, I noticed his profile picture was that of him and his new bride. I offered him a phone call to get in touch with her, but he declined. As promised, I completed the paperwork as fast as I could and he was released on his own recognizance to return to court in a few weeks. When I spoke with the prosecutor's office, I had to disclose this relationship. The attorney said he was worried that the defense might try to make the case that I arrested him because I might have had a grudge against him. I disagreed. I argued that it showed good judgment on my part and that I was able to do exactly as I had sworn to do, which was uphold the law equally. The case won't be resolved for a few more months, but I suspect he'll pay for the damages in exchange for having the charges dropped. Interesting thing though that I remembered from high school. Though we attended the same high school, he didn't graduate from our high school. A semester before he was due to graduate, he was arrested in a prank gone bad for destruction of property and was kicked out. He had to graduate from a nearby high school. I'd also like to say that I have run into other people in the past that I've known through the course of my job. In times where I feel I'd be too biased one way or another, I've requested that other police officers handle the scene call, and it's worked out quite well. I gave a very senior police officer's son a peewee ticket once, or more properly a penalty notice for disorder for public urination. He paid it very quickly and nothing more was said about it. For what it's worth, he did tell me who his dad was and I recognized the surname, but he only told me after he was given the ticket and it was issued and dealt with in the normal way. I think there might have been a few red faces. I've never come across a situation where I needed to arrest a close friend or someone close to me though. I guess it helps that I don't live anywhere near where I work. I had to arrest an old school friend once for burglary. Never saw him again afterwards though. We'd lost contact after school, so the thought of meeting up with him afterwards. Yes, friend, he was drunk and driving. Wasn't a friend afterward, but he was alive and didn't kill anyone that night. So, fair trade. You did the right thing and no one needs someone who blames you for their own mistakes as a friend. When I was a freshman in high school, we had an unusually aggressive group of seniors who would pick on us often. Note, no, I did not become a cop because I got picked on when I was 15. I didn't even decide I wanted to trial until I was 25. Just saying. So out of the entire year, there was one person who ever stuck up for me and I have always been thankful that one of their peers who was their size was willing to stand up to them. Anyway, flash forward to my first week as a reserve police officer. Volunteer police to learn the job and gain experience prior to applying full-time. Uniform, gun, badge etc. Just no paycheck. We go to a call of someone drunk falling through the window of a business. Show up for my first arrest and guess who? The guy. The one person who ever stuck up for me and I had no ability to help him because I was brand new and had no clout at the time. The worst part was when he was in cuffs and looked at me repeating, "Really? Really?" I haven't forgot that moment and it actually played a large part on how I treated people when I was an officer actually. 8 years and resigned now. I have since touched base with him and thanked him for what he did for me in high school. He hasn't fallen through any windows since and he's doing well. Haha. Pulled my mom over on the side of a busy highway. She totally did not know it was me and I let her go with a hug. Saw plenty of people I knew in jail. Neighbors. People I went to school with. Oh no. It's the very scary pancake man comment. I am not scared to make him go away. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check out another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.